The big challenge is you're telling someone's life. You're telling a true story. Not only that, you're telling the story of someone who can't be here. So the book was very much from Sinjar's point of view, which it has to be. It's his memoir. I knew the film had to follow Kate home. And I knew, therefore, that we are presenting Kate to an audience. And it's a massive responsibility, and it's a challenge. And what you do is you share that responsibility and that challenge with the most professional people. And our crew and our cast, led by Amelia Fox and Rafe Spall, they understood the nuances of this story, which is a tragic, beautiful romance. And the joy of it and the pleasure that came from it was everyone realizing how special this was and how privileged we were to tell this story. I actually have a very personal connection. I live in the town where it happened. My boys, Tom and Joe, they go to the same school as Reef and Finn. I knew Kate in the last year of her life. At first, I was slightly resistant to being involved in the film because I knew that there's risks in presenting a story like this in a film. And I said to Sinjar, I'll stand by you and I'll help you when the producers and the directors want to alter your story. Gradually, I began to realize that actually I could tell the version that I felt comfortable with that was actually being defined by those same rules that I was going to hand over to Sinj. And I think the joy of doing it is finding a bunch of people you work with who understand the delicacies and the nuances and were working so hard in every shoot. There's moments when crew come up and say, oh, it was an amazing scene. I really felt, oh, happens in every shoot. Here, the fact that they knew that we were walking in the footsteps of the real people because we were filming in that town, that these events actually happened to someone, and that the other person who's still here, Sinj, you would come for breakfast, and everyone got to know him. It became this beautiful family affair, and that was a real privilege to be in the middle of all of that. I think the value of taking one family in particular, is what Kate's List did was arm Sinj. It's not a bucket list. She wasn't writing the things she wants to do. When Sinj said to her in the last 3 months of her life, how do I cope without you? She began by giving him quite simplistic instructions, very basic instructions. And then she realized this was her chance. This is her chance to remain. We all want to remain. We all want to feel that we're remembered. Most of us have the benefit of a long, long life for us to be memories, living memories within our families. But she knew she had to create this. And that list became this profound memorializing of herself. So I think this family in particular, their story has meaning within the greater context of how cancer touches us. And there's a woman who put herself out there. She gave Sinj the armory that he used to help move on. Rafe and Millie are incredible in this film. They're both parents. They're both people who have experienced love. And they also understand humanity, and I think that's the biggest thing. They've got heart, both of them. With Millie, it was a chance. I know Millie very well from working with her 10 years ago in Keeping Mum. And there's a side to Millie that's warm and loving, which sometimes her roles don't allow her to present. And I knew that she has those qualities. With Rafe, he's a man who can just take a scene and turn it into something massively profound. He has such a heart. They both do. And I felt we want people who are normal people, who we can fall in love with. The film is there to make people fall in love with Kate and with Sinj. I think that there's no better than Rafe and Millie to communicate that. I hope this film most achieves spreading a bit of love. I think we should all remember life is short, we have one chance, and we should make the most of every moment with those we love and who love us. There's nothing better than doing that.